us earlier in the week. He said, you know, this guy is just a good quarterback. He makes things happen. And you can see it right there.
Yeah, second down and 2, an 8-yard gain. Hand off, and once again, it's Mills searching for room. Went over that left side. And got a pretty good gain on it. Or no, excuse me, that was Rudolph, Chris Rudolph, who carried it that time. And I wonder a little bit when I think about this, if the fact that you have so many Marist players going both ways, being out on that field for so long of a time, is it starting to wear a little bit, especially against some of these bigger Buffalo Grove players?
Well, I'm sure that's true, because you've only got your defense for Buffalo Grove playing 50% of the time, the same with the offense. And the big thing is the amount of practice time they get. And we'll get into that in a minute. Let's get to play.
All right, two wideouts or a single wideout on the play. Benson's going to keep it, fake the pitch. Up the field he goes to the 40 and carried it all the way down to the 37-yard line. Another first down for Buffalo Grove, and they are really digging in now.
Well, there are not enough superlatives to talk about that young man by the name of Benson with a number 22. I think he must think he's Doug Flutie with that number.
I was thinking maybe with the name of Benson, he wanted his own TV show.
Well, here it is right here. He fakes the fullback, keeps the ball on the option, comes back out. I don't know if I like the way he holds on to that ball, but he sure makes the yardage. But you notice as he went down, he knows how to tuck the ball
in. He sure does. First and 10, 9-11 left. Fourth quarter. Buffalo Grove with a 20-0 lead and driving. Motion man. Pitch goes to Mills as Rudolph went in motion, and Mills carries the ball to the 30, to the 29-yard line. That's a mighty good gain. Now everything's starting to work. Tom Wallenberg was there to knock him off his feet.
Now we'll see Mills right here on the pitch. Benson pitches the ball. Rudolph leading the play.
Yeah.
And then, of course, he gets caught from behind by the linebacker.
Gain of 8, second down and 2.
Look at the rushing now, and that, I think, tells the story. Buffalo Grove has 133 yards, Marist 43.
Any questions? Not really. 8:25 left here in the fourth quarter. Marist has played a stubborn football game. They have played their hearts out today. Hand off Mills, going off left tackle to the 28 or 27, perhaps. You know, they're getting good gains on first down, too, Bill. You're looking at second down and 2 here. Boy, they put a lot of pressure on you just because they can gamble.
Well, here's another look. They're giving it to the second back through. Rudolph takes the linebacker around, and Mills just comes right up. It's just a regular old power play. Well, we were talking about the two platooning that Buffalo Grove has, and the situation is such that when you have 4 or 5 days to practice, sometimes when you have kids going both ways, that means they only get 2.5 days of offense, 2.5 days of defense. That's not the case with Buffalo Grove.
Yeah.
They have a full 5 days of offense, a full 5 days of defense. So you get a lot more learning in. And now as we look there, the ball is just short of the first down, Bill.
All right, just a few inches. I think, Bill, too, that you're implying that you get to work much more as a unit, too. These guys know each other probably a lot better.
Right, and of course, there's some problems with it, too, but the pluses certainly outweigh the negatives.
As it would seem. Third down, less than a yard. Not a foot to go. Play action fake. Benson puts it up. Has his receiver down the far sideline. Beautiful reception. And a backup receiver for Buffalo Grove made the catch.
Well, that was a gutty call. Everybody's looking for the run. A great fake by Benson. And he just comes out, rolls out, lets the ball go. And the tight end is
Jim Wagner caught the ball.
Right.
How about that? Well, that breaks up the two platoon football right there.
Well, I think they're just trying to have a little fun now and let everybody get into it.
Well, Jim Wagner just caught a large game. That caught me totally by surprise. First and goal at the 4-yard line. Benson to fake. The pitch to Mills. He'll go in. Touchdown. Buffalo Grove up 26-0. And they'll be celebrating in the Northwest suburbs tonight.
Well, you don't know how many times Wagner's had the opportunity to play offense. They probably said, hey, he's playing defense once in a while. Let's let him catch the football. His last time, he's been here since he's been a sophomore.
Yeah.
And that's the fun of the game. That's what it's all about.
Well, they must have put in, I'm sure they must have worked in practice with the idea that if they could get Wagner into the game offensively, maybe that's a little something that he wanted to do, and coach respecting his wishes wanted to give him the chance. see what it was like. All right, a lot of wideouts here now. A lot of wideouts. 2-point conversion attempt, Benson from the shotgun. Up he comes. He's going to be caught and dropped. Good defensive play by Tom Wallenberg, Jr., number three tackler. And so, the score holds at 26-0. We have 7:25 left. We'll be coming back for the 6A state championship.
For a limited time only, you'll save on MasterCare front disc brake service, just $69.95. Or save on Ridemaster shock absorbers, just $7.95 plus installation. At Firestone, you can charge it. Come on, drive over to Firestone for MasterCare car service. For the store nearest you, call 325-3152.
Firestone. Feel the excitement of Notre Dame basketball as Sports Vision brings you the best of the Fighting Irish all season long. Don't miss head coach Digger Felt and his explosive team, led by one of America's premier point guards, All-America and Player of the Year candidate, David Rivers. Join former basketball star Jim Gibbons and myself, Tom Denon, through an outstanding season of Notre Dame basketball. Follow the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame only on Sports Vision, Chicago's winners on cable.
Here's the kickoff now. The ball carries to the 25-yard line and up the field comes one of the backup runners for Marist, Pasternak, Peter Pasternak, who handles up the kickoff return. And so Marist will put it in play, first and 10.
Well, I think you're going to see the ball in the air now.
Oh, yeah, not much choice here. Let's take a look at this last touchdown. Mills with good outside speed.
We fake the fullback, and there's the pitch. And, of course, there's nobody there because of the kind of blocking that Buffalo drove put on at the goal line.
That's where, I tell you what, that's where that option really looks great, too. Berry looking toward the near side. He's going to have to put it up. He's flushed out. He'll run with it. Gets across the 45 to the 46-yard line, but Marist has no choice. They have to go to the air here and get that clock stopped. Good gain on the play, enough for a first down. That time, Kevin Berry made chicken out of chicken stuff.
Well, sometimes you have to do that. There's the Buffalo Grove scoring drive. 8 plays, 76 yards, 3:45, and of course, Mills makes that run on the option.
That really freezes that defensive end, doesn't it? He comes, he packs that defensive end, and the moment that guy takes the bait, bang, the ball's pinned
back. And of course, if you don't have the safety coming in to make the play, and that's why you have to worry sometimes. That's why you want to vary up the kind of defense you play against an option.
Berry has wideouts on both sides of the field, drops to the 40, under pressure, throws it. Has a man out of the backfield, and Resenda, who came in as a replacement for Dave Seastrom, carried the ball. Jeff Cook was there to make the stop. The ball plays just across midfield, and I think they got a first down out of it. Or did they?
Well, you can see it right here, Bill. Throwing to the fullback. That's a safety valve. He throws to the fullback when he can't get anybody else open. It's Brad Deanna makes the catch, makes the reception. They're able to move the ball.
Gain of 5, second down and 5. Over the middle again, and the ball is caught. Another good gain as the reception made by Mike Hackett, the tight end. Senior playing his last football game, as are many on this football field today. 6:11 remaining. Marist trying to move. I tell you what, Marist has not shown a bad offensive attack, Bill. They've moved the ball down the field.
No, it's been mistakes that have been made, and that's what cost the game.
Again, another good sideline route. This time, Bullitt. If he breaks free, he may go all the way. He's dragged down.
At the one.
Inside the 5, down near the goal line. Wow. Bullitt.
Nice run. He really made that. The tightrope was right there, and he took it. Let's take a look at it on a replay. We can see just how tight he had to run down the sideline.
Nice throw.
Keeps his balance. He's right down the line and then makes a great move to start to go to the pylon.
Alan Shields was there in pass coverage, and he was stretched out as well, so that ball had to be perfectly thrown. It'll be first and goal at the one. Marist wants to get in. And a touchdown as the ball is given to Redzienda, Mike Redzienda. They bring him in near the goal line. He's an outstanding blocker, and this time he carried one over.
Well, that has to be a real thrill for him. He's a reserve fullback. He gets in the game because Seastrom is injured, and then he gets to score a touchdown. So even though you're on the short end of the stick as far as the championship game is concerned, at least there's some individual things that you can drive from a football game like this.
Under 6 minutes remaining, 5:56 the time of the score. That makes it 26-6, and they will try for the extra point. Malarkey is on. Kevin Berry will hold. Malarkey puts it up. It hit the goal post and bounced out. It bounced out. How about that? Well, that's when you know things aren't going very well.
Well, of course, I think you had an indication of that the first time they tried a field goal when they moved the ball on their first possession, moved it down on Buffalo Grove, then went for the field goal, and then, of course, came up short.
Yeah. Well, the score holds at 26-6. And how about that? You know, isn't that how it often comes up in a game like this? You figure to see the big stars make the difference in a game. But in the first game, for example, Dave Kuser, the performance of Dave Kuser, the guy he wouldn't have heard as much about. We've heard about Graham. We've heard about all these big people.
And here's the touchdown with Brad Tienda, the reserve fullback, sticking his nose in there and getting that touchdown.
Went right over the left side.
But now with the kickoff, Bill, what, you're down 26-6. What's the possibility of an onside kick?
Well, the way he's lining up and the way everybody else is lining up, if this isn't an offside kick, this is the most unusual regular kick formation I've ever seen. Everybody's over to the left side, it seems right now. That could change, however, before the ball is actually kicked. Let's see.
Well, I have to be honest. I've never seen one like this.
All right, they've got a big start. A lot of momentum. The ball is bounced, and it is covered by Buffalo Grove, and a big pile up. The ball's loose. It was recovered by Buffalo Grove.
I tell you what, I kind of like that onside
kick.
That's not a bad idea. Just get them running, get them going, and just wham a ball down. It's kind of like bowling. You just bowl the balls down and knock them down.
Yeah, but instead of a bowling ball, you get two bowling balls with a rod in between them, and then roll it down. You know you're going to get them all with that.
That's right. And then just what you have to do is have one guy who gets the ball, have him block him, and have the next guy come up and pick it up. It's kind of like when you're playing football in the city, you know, and you got to be to the Pontiac, and you go to the light post, and say you turn over there at the Buick and catch the ball.
You saw that Marist drive. They moved down the field once again very well. Here's Benson, the quarterback, still in there. Might see Mark Brent before the day is over. And a big hit. The ball was given off. Jerry Joyce, coming across the line of scrimmage, made a super hit on Chris Rudolph. This has been the story in the scoring in the game. Marist unable to get on the board until the fourth quarter. Really, the third quarter was the key, I think, for Buffalo Grove.
Here's the hit. Boy, Jerry Joyce really came in there. Tremendous penetration. Makes the hit. Too bad they couldn't have done that when the game was a little bit closer. Although Jerry Joyce has played a fine football game.
He has. Second down and 13, and it's good to see that Marist has not let up one bit. They're faking a blitz. They're bringing somebody. Pass on the flat to Mills. And he got over the 45. And then was brought down. He had a linebacker. Wallenberg was pinching right up there at the line of scrimmage, Bill, on the right side.
Now, I think the difference as far as Buffalo Grove is concerned has been the play of Mills, and we'll see it right here. Mark Benson throws the ball out to Mills. Mills has some speed, and I said this before, it really surprises me. I saw a number of films on him, and I didn't realize he was quite that fast, and we saw him in practice.
Yeah, that's right, and he didn't look all that fast in practice, but then again, it was 30 degrees that day. Mark Benson, to the moment, you can see the job that he has done. High formation, they put a man in motion, Mills. Benson rolling out, he's in trouble. Trying to turn it up. Turned on the jets, up the field he goes. Hemstreet could not hang on to it, and it was nearly intercepted by Jim Palubin. Nearly it picked off.
Well, Mark Benson, and that was the same play that they used to score a touchdown. Only he was looking for the tight end. I was trying to see if Jim Wagner, number 86, was in there. Perhaps maybe they were trying to throw the ball to him to get him a little bit more fun and a little more reception. But he kept looking back. Mark Benson kept looking back for the throwback. Never could find it.
Most quarterbacks would have been caught for a loss there, too, Bill. We saw a good idea of the great athletic ability that he has.
Well, and the other thing was, you get over the line of scrimmage. He was really rolling out. I thought he might have thrown an illegal forward pass.
Sheedy waiting for the ball. Bullich is the deep man on fourth down. Ball does not travel that well. Bullich misplays it, falls on it, covers it at the 25-yard line. That ball kind of died up there.
Well, as I said before, I don't know if you've ever tried to kick a ball when it's really cold out, but that hurts your toes.
A As a matter of fact, I have. I used to kick them into the trees in our old home in Arlington Heights years ago.
Now there's Bulich. He makes a mistake, but he's able to cover the ball pretty well. And that, if anything, he lost a few yards, but he certainly didn't lose the ball.
First and 10 at the 25. Caney is the wide out to the near side. And Mansky to the near side. The throwing for Caney. Way downfield. He's open. Oh, my goodness. That was six right there. Mike Kay was beaten on the play. And Berry only missed connecting with Caney by about a foot and a half.
And I think that epitomizes the game that we're seeing today. He missed the ball by about 3 inches. And Marist, even though the score is not going to indicate it, I think missed this football game by about 3 inches.
Yeah.
A play here or there, and this game would have been turned around, Bill.
Yeah, and yet you look at the numbers on him. He has played a very, very good game, as you say, but they missed that big play. And that was a real good, I really think it was a pretty good representation of the game as a whole. Caney to the far side. Berry going over the middle, and it is incomplete. At the 35-yard line, the receiver was taken down hard. It was the tight end, Mike Hackett, coming over the middle. Chad Dobre was there.
Well, we've got a few happy people from Buffalo Grove. You can tell where they're from.
Yeah, I was going to say, is there any doubt? Is there any doubt? They are only 3.5 minutes away from celebrating a championship. Their team leading 26-6. Barring a major miracle, an upset of unbelievable proportion here, the Bison will have quite a pep rally coming up in the Northwest Suburbs. Here's Berry on the drop. He's played a fine game in defeat. Berry looking, goes back across the field for Mansky. Oh, and he almost caught that. What a deflection. Mansky's a pretty smart little player, isn't he?
Well, that was a reflection by Chad Dobre, and we can see it right here. He really lets the air under that football, and he's got Mansky, but Dobre comes in and makes the play, and the ball's still up in the air, and he almost catches it again. That's been the ball game for the Marist Redskins.
They've been close, but no cigar. 3:20 remaining. And the sun, of course, went down about an hour and a half ago, and we have rather cool conditions now. Berry makes it real tough. Those linemen are working awfully hard in the cold. Berry scrambling all over the place. He has some room to throw, but he's going to his left against his momentum, and he's finally tackled down. Tackle was made by Tom Bruno, the linebacker who shot through. He's been involved on a number of them today.
And I think you'll see this. This is total frustration now for the Marist Redskins. Kevin Berry's out scrambling, looking all over the place, trying to find a wide receiver or any kind of a receiver. And there's a shoestring tackle, and Kevin Berry goes down. And, of course, there's the exuberant Buffalo Grove defense.
Marist runs out of downs. The ball goes over. Buffalo Grove has it back. We'll see. We expect to see some new players in here pretty quickly. Probably we'll see if there's a new quarterback. Yes, Rick Friend is in there. Whole new backfield. Curtis Ganji in the lineup right now. Double tight set. Handoff is given to the other man in that backfield. Oh, he wants to go to that goal line, doesn't he? Dale Benson, a third stringer, gets the ball. Hit was finally made by Jerry Joyce after a gain of a couple. Actually, he got a good gain on it, about 6 yards.
Well, you know, when you're a reserve, you don't have very many chances. So when you've got the chance to go for a touchdown, you want to go for it with all the gusto you can.
Well, that's right. So Benson and Gunji are the running backs right now. Well, they have a full house. They have another man in there. Friend. Handoff. And carrying the ball this time, Paul Vance. He is a junior. Backup fullback. Probably will figure prominently in the attack next year.
Well, Rick Friend, the quarterback that's in there right now, his brother plays at the University of Illinois. We'll see Rick Friend handing the ball off to a junior fullback who certainly hopes that he's down here again a year from now.
Yep. Like to put them back to back. This is three straight playoff appearances for Buffalo Grove. They've built a real powerhouse. And of course, it was only a year ago when we saw East St. Louis winning the state title for the umpteenth straight year. But there will be a new 6A champion tonight. Deep pitch. Ball is carried, and a good quick run that time by Ganji. He has some speed. Curtis Ganji. He stands 5'10", 155 pounds. We're down a minute 25 left. And now a lot of the other players that work so hard in practice getting a chance.
We'll see the pitch. They put a man in motion trying to get a lead blocker out front. And there's Gagne. Doesn't quite have the speed that Mills does, but I'm sure he'll work on it so he's a better football player for next year.
Jerry Joyce was there to bring him down. First down and five. First and goal at the 5-yard line. And a handoff, no room for Paul Vance that time. A number of tacklers up there. We mentioned Jerry Joyce. He is the son of Senator Jeremiah Joyce playing in this game. He has a great nose for the football. And as a senior, he will finish his career captain of this team. I know he has to be, although not pleased about the situation, it's been a very nice year.
Well, you know, he's not all that big, Jerry Joyce, but he certainly is effective. He's 5'11", 195, which by some standards now isn't it all that big for a linebacker.
Second down and goal inside the 5-yard line. And the ball comes loose. It's picked up by Marist and will be advanced out to the 20-yard line. The man who was there and picked up the loose change for Marist was number 55, Andy Buska, a linebacker, 6 feet 200.
Hey, we'll catch it here on the replay. Again, this is the lineman's dream. Pick up that fumble. The exchange is poor. There's the fumble. There he comes in and makes the play. He has a little speed. He might have had a touchdown.
Well, that's how it is with all of them, you know. If they all had a little speed, they would have actually had a good angle coming out of the gate, though.
If they all had a little speed, they wouldn't have that odd-looking number, 55. They'd have a 32 or 22.
You're right. You're right about that, or one.
Right.
As a flanker. New quarterback going in. We'll see. He's not even on our chart. Rick
Ryan.
Ryan is going to come in here.
Well, it's kind of ironic.
Green, actually, yeah.
You have two quarterbacks that are backups. Both of their brothers are in the Big Ten. Friend being at Illinois, Ryan being at Michigan.
Well, that's interesting now. So it's a family affair, isn't it?
Well.
Family affair. So Green is coming in now. Plays both ways. Rick, the backup quarterback, is also a very skilled punter. And it'll be first and 10 at the 20. 24 seconds left. Green has new backs behind him. 24 seconds from a victory celebration for Buffalo Grove. Hand off. And straight ahead running there for another backup runner for Marist. The ball was given to Larry Tischer, number 21. He gained some yardage, got up to about the 22. The clock runs. They stopped him with 19. They're using the timeout. Trying to get as many players into the game now as possible. So they have the sensation of being there. And, Bill, I think this is one of the most graceful gestures that any coach ever gives, is getting a chance to see some of these kids. After all, they work hard in practice. They have every reason to hope, if possible, if the game is not close, to get in.
Well, everybody works hard in practice. The reward is playing in the football game.
Yep.
And, of course, that's what you're getting. And, you know, there always has to be a winner and a loser in a championship game, but I think you have to keep it in perspective, and you have to remember that everybody else has already lost, and you're in a championship game that nobody else is here.
That's right. As the old saying goes, and I think it's very true, for every team except one, the season finishes on a losing note. And that's really what it all boils down to. So Marist has certainly nothing to be ashamed of at all. They've had a good year. They can go home very happy about what they've accomplished. Coach Peter Zach can be very, very proud of his players and of everything they've done. The dream has been a good dream. All they did was they didn't win the championship. And that's no disgrace to anybody. And as for Buffalo Grove, well, I guarantee you they're going to be a happy bunch.
Well, of course, you have to look at it from the other side. This is the first time that Marist has been here. Buffalo Grove has been here once before and didn't win it. They came back the next time and they won it.
And that's often what happens. Sometimes you mention that being there for the first time, the expectations are different. Green dropping back. Nice drop up the middle. He'll go. Explodes to the 35. His hit dropped at the 37, 38-yard line. Tackle finally made. And so the clock running down, holding at 10 seconds. Chris Woolard was there to make the hit. Backup defensive back. Chris, second or third stringer, cousin of Doug Woolard on this team. And several, this is kind of a family affair, I'll tell you. Both these schools. Take a look at the last play. Reed showed us a little skill. He had a nice drop and took off.
Well, he's a junior, and of course, he's not small. He's 6'3", 180 pounds. He turns it up right there. He's looking for as many yards as he can, and then he takes a real hit.
Now, Marist fans are getting an early look at next year's likely starting quarterback if he continues to perform well. We should mention that a little irony about the 5A and 6A game, Bill, is that both of the winning teams will have a 20-point victory margin if the score should remain as it is.
Right, and of course, I think the sideline to that is this game has been a lot closer in terms of the way it was played than I think the 5A championship.
Yes, which was a wild game. I tell you what, I enjoyed the 5A game a great, great deal. We were entertained very, very well.
Well, Bill, maybe we could promote another game, the 5A against the 6A next week.
Sounds great. You get the stadium, and I'll get the hot dog.
All right.
Double wideouts here for Reen as he brings him up. He'll look to throw. Time running out. Reen throws it way down the field, over the head of an intended wide receiver for Marist, the backup coming in. That stops the clock. Mike Manning, another wide receiver. A lot of new names in here. This is what we call, referred to in the sports announcing biz, is going totally off the depth chart.
Well, thank goodness for the flip card when we get to this point.
Oh, yeah, yeah, right. Usually I don't use them that much. We all have our own material that we prepare for these games. But there's a point where you just can't hold all the entire roster, so you try to get the main ones. And knowing in a situation like this that we'll be seeing a lot of new names. So players getting a chance to feel what it is to be in a state championship game. Even losing, it'll be the thrill of the memory of a lifetime just to be here in Bloomington. And we're going to be sticking around afterwards to have some of the celebration. They have all intercepted. This will be the final game of the play of the game. Reen had his pass picked off. It was deflected. Ray Sheedy was the guy who picked it off for Buffalo Grove, or excuse me, Jeff Schwartz, number 31, a defensive back. Now number 30, Jeff Schwartz. And with that, Buffalo Grove punctuates a state championship. They have won it all.
Well, look at all that happiness.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. And they can be very, very happy. Their head coach, Grant Blaney, in his 14th season. It took him 14 years to get here and win this game. This is the moment of a lifetime for him and his team.
Right, and of course, in a lot of cases, a lot of coaches have won the state championship, and retirement isn't far off. I don't know if that's true with Grant Blaney or not.
Well, I tell you what more can you do? You know, you get to that point, if you've achieved it all, what more can you do? And I can understand why a lot of people do.
One of the things you want is back-to-back work.
Yeah, like Al McGuire, for example, in basketball, decided to, you know, he won that championship. Of course, he had decided beforehand, but the rule is still true in many cases. And who knows, with what they have coming back, they have a lot of strong players. They may be in a position to put some back-to-back titles into the IHSA record books. We have Ann Myers with Grant Blaney, the head coach of Buffalo Grove, alongside. Annie?
Coach Blaney, congratulations on her 14-0 season.
Thank you. It seems like we talked 6 hours ago.
No, it's so long.
I'm happy for the kids. I'm happy for the coaches. I'm happy for the community, the school, everybody. So it's a great thrill. It's
That's
a great thrill. One of my greatest thrills, obviously.
Were you kind of surprised that you held them only to one touchdown?
Well, I felt it was going to be a low-scoring game. I was surprised we scored four. I thought we could score two, and I thought maybe they could get one off of us, and that was it. I thought it was going to be a much closer game defensively.
It was pretty even in the first half. In the second half, defensively, you did a super job, and Pat Mills did great job.
They all did. Benson, the quarterback, the offensive line. But the defense kept us in there. They kept us close. They kept the pressure on them. It was a total team victory. I mean, the offense did what they had to do when they were in there, and the defense, of course, you know, dominated when they had to. And I thought our kicking game was pretty sound, too. And so everything fell into place. Once in a lifetime.
Congratulations,
Thank you, dear. Thank you very much.
Take care. Bill Gorley, Bill Hazen, back to you.
Thank you, Ann. Go in and get warm now. And it was a great, great state championship final. I'm Bill Hazen. Bill Gorley will be back. We'll wrap things up here when we return to the Bloomington Normal area on the campus of Illinois State.
Your handyman works hard all year round, so give him a hand with hard-working gifts from True Value Hardware Stores. He can handle a variety of soldering jobs with the Weller Soldering Gun Kit for just $16.99. And locate hidden studs easily with the Zircon Stud Sensor for only $14.99. For big repairs, give him the Master Mechanic Self-Igniting Torch for just $21.99.
and he can form strong, lasting bonds with their solid-state glue gun for only $9.99 at most True Value hardware stores.
When the Blackhawks are on the road this season, they're as close as your television as Sport Vision brings you live, exclusive action of exciting Blackhawk hockey. It may be cold outside, but the action is always hot. As the Calgary Flames play host to our Blackhawks, live from the Saddle Dome, Saturday night, November 29th at 7 p.m. Blackhawk hockey, all season long, only on Sports Vision. Chicago's winners on cable.
It's the UIC Flames exclusively on Sports Vision. Feel the heat as the Flames try to take control of the Central Collegiate Hockey Association. With head coach Val Belmonte at the helm. And don't miss the UIC men's basketball team as coach Willie Little brings leading scorer Bobby Locke and center Nate Chambers through an action-packed season of UIC basketball. It's the UIC Flames, only on Sports Vision, Chicago's winners on cable.
Those of us with Sports Vision are so happy to have been able to bring you the state champion game. It's been years since it's been on television. We're happy to do it. Bill Gurley, thank you so much. I've enjoyed your input tremendously. You've done a super, super job.
Well, I've enjoyed doing this again, and we can't wait for 3 years like the last day.
Yeah, it sure hope not. We want to thank our spotter, Tim Dunn. You're going to be seeing everybody who was involved in our telecast, and we want to give our thanks. The state champions will head off the field. Buffalo Grove, a winner. Our next college football game will be tomorrow, November 30th at 8 o'clock, when Florida takes on Florida State. We invite you to be tuned for that Gators and Seminoles game. The executive producer for tonight's game, Jim Corno. Tonight's game has been produced and directed by Harlan Singer. The associate directors, Pete DiGiulio and Mark Stenzel. The studio coordinator, Steve Corman. And remote facilities, as always, provided by Trio Video. Stay with us now. We have an evening of football and a whole lot of things coming up, starting with the Doug Buffon Rich King football show in progress. We'll join it at 7. It's NHL action as the Blackhawks travel to Calgary to take on the Flames. Bill Hazen for Ann Myers and Bill Gurley. Final score in our championship games, 5A, Wheaton North 34, Mount Carmel 14, and Buffalo Grove defeating Marist in the 6A, 26-6. That is the story here from Illinois State for this evening. The preceding has been an exclusive Sports Vision presentation.
Greatest guy going now is Testaverde. But how do you get Testaverde in an absence like they'll be take the shot at him? I think what the Bears are going to try to do is cultivate what they have. And I think there is a young kid out there that looks good. You may see him on a latter round. The Bears may take a shot at him. But right now, I believe that Mike Dick in the back of his mind is thinking, well, how good is Flutie? Everyone's talked about him. Everyone said he did tremendous things in college, but no one really knows until he gets under fire. And I think that's why he wants to take a look at him. So that part is up in the air.
Okay, I got one more question for the wives here. When you watch a game, thank you, sir. Very much. Sorry. When you watch a game, Leslie, first of all, what do you watch? Do you watch Emery or do you watch the play?
I watch Emery first. And then I watch the play. If he's totally out of it, then I'll finish watching the play. But I always watch him blocking. I watch him going out for the pass. I watch to see whether he's open. I watch him.
Penny, that's tougher for you on the inside of that line, isn't it?
No, I watch him. He teaches me the play, so I know if he makes a mistake or not. But I watch him.
Finally,
I don't watch where the ball goes. I just concentrate on my husband.
Finally, Penny, if you had one word of advice to a young lady who was married to a football player, what would it be?
Don't marry him?
No, just have confidence in yourself and your husband and your relationship.
Leslie, how about you?
Oh, that's a hard one. Just don't let things get to you. Because a lot of things can get to you being a player's wife. And you just have to kind of just go with the flow and just let things go as they may.
Okay, let's have a big hand for Leslie and Penny here for a nice job. All right, thank you both very much. Really appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you.
All right, back with the husbands here on Sports Vision after this.
Some of the best workshops rely on accessories from True Value Hardware Stores, like the rugged Plano Tote More with drawer and carrying handle for just $5.29. Brighten dark areas with a Woods Wire retractable reel light for only $14.99. The Master Mechanic two-piece mini locking fire set is $9.99, less a $3 mail-in rebate. And the Snap-It Power Strip with eight grounded receptacles is also just $9.99 at most True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
The Midwest number one Nissan dealer has America's number one selling import cars at king-size discounts. Ray Hera, the king of Nissan, says nobody sells Nissans for less, including the all-new restyled 1987 Pulsar NX. The King's Pulsar NX is the affordable new sports car with the new twin-cam 16-valve performance and new T-top design. Test drive a King Nissan Pulsar NX today. Drive it home tonight. Remember, if you don't get the King's price, you'll probably pay too much. Nobody sells Nissans for less than Ray Hera's King Nissan, home of king-size discounts. 6200 West 2E in Niles.
All right, welcome back to Mike Ditka's Place. Rich King back with you along with Doug Buffone on the Doug Buffone-Rich King Show for our next segment here. And we've had the wives on, of course, of Emery Moorhead and Jimbo Covert. And now the men themselves. Let's welcome aboard Jimbo Covert and Emery Moorhead of the Chicago Bears.
All right.
Gentlemen, glad to have you both here. How would you rate the wives' performance?
Very good. They did well.
Yeah, they
were excited about it.
I like the way she plugged my program. She's great.
She did her well. I really
did. She did her real well. Okay, not much to talk about this week, huh?
No, nothing ever happens up there in Lake Forest.
It's so boring up there.
I know. I don't know what to say.
Well, first of all, let me ask you both, Jimbo, first of all, the reaction about Jim, what the mood of the team is, and to go on from here, I guess, is what you have to have.
Well, you know, I guess things happen in life, and you just have to overcome them. He's not going to play the rest of the year, and we just have to find out what kind of character our football team is. And I know last year we had a lot of character, and I think we do this year. It's just that we're faced with this extenuating circumstance, and we're just all going to have to rally behind Mike Tomczak, because I really do feel he's going to be a good player in this league. He just needs confidence, and the only way you're going to get confidence is by playing, and that's all he can do, and we're all behind him.
Emery, at the brunch about a week ago, you came out with a very strong